Impatience, Developing the Virtue of Patience, written by Christian Olsen, narrated by Sam Slydell. Introduction. In this book, you'll find the hidden secrets of developing more patience. Although sadly, I am still in the process of developing this virtue myself, I strongly encourage you to look at the facts and principles in this book and take them to heart. We have a problem. We all do. We are humans, and we don't like waiting, especially in this century, with, instead, gratification on demand, whether that's online or local. The solution is hard, and it's something everyone needs to work on. This book will help you develop more patience. The insights and thoughts in this book come from trusted leaders, peaceful gurus, and clever philosophers. The impact this knowledge can have on your life is immense. Changing your attitude and being able to wait is essential to your happiness, your success, and your future, both in this world and the world to come. So don't wait, how ironic, and keep reading on so you too can find out how to take your life to the next level by harboring the crucial virtue of patience. Chapter 1. Patience is a virtue. Patience has been defined as the capacity to accept or tolerate delay, trouble, or suffering without getting angry or upset. Just from the definition itself, we can turn to some soul-searching questions about our behavior and everyday repertoire of reacting to the vicissitudes and altering circumstances around us. When life presents its quick, sudden changes of direction to us, how do we deal with them? Do we complain? Do we throw a tantrum? Do we sigh? Do we blame others? Do we play the victim? Do we become angry? It all seems so simple, yet so many people have a hard time with this concept, patience. As human beings, we are stuck in the dimension of time, despite the fact that an eternal, inner voice softly whispers to us that we are not at home in this limitation. Like a homesick child, we earnestly yearn for those things we cannot have, those things which seem out of reach, simply because the one thing in this world destroys and defeats everything and everyone. Time is the big indicator of our worldly estate, a temporal existence we leave within a heartbeat, or, to be more accurate, the period of less than a century. It's interesting that the definition mentions three things. 1. Delay. 2. Trouble. 3. Suffering. Although the three of them overlap each other at times, I still want to discuss these in more detail. When things are delayed, we experience a loss. Our expectations aren't being met, and something we wanted or didn't want anymore has been postponed, i.e., delayed. This isn't always easy because it literally causes disappointment. Just like when we grieve when we lose a loved one, when we don't get what we want, need, or expect, it can be considered a loss as well, despite the fact that it may not be as severe as having someone die. Still, a loss is a loss, and it can be painful. The same is true for trouble. When things become more complicated or more difficult to achieve, when things go wrong or circumstances are out of control, we tend to panic and not patiently wait for our situation to get better or simply take action without being worried. Suffering is such a broad term. We can suffer emotionally, physically, or in other ways. Someone who suffers from the most extreme torture, illness, or damage inflicted by others could probably tell you how much patience they had to have to endure their, often undeserved, circumstances. The virtue of patience can give you emotional strength and wisdom as you go through life. Being patient with people basically means that we understand that they make mistakes, like us, and that we don't judge them for their supposed intentions. It means we forgive. We don't hold them accountable, or we simply don't bother thinking the worst of them, despite their actions. It means that we don't give up on them, and that we still hope that they still change for the better, even when progress seems to be limited for a small period of time. If we do that with others, they are more inclined to do it with us. Sometimes, a lot of time actually, what we want or need will eventually come, but not at our own timetable. Whether you believe in God, the universe, or simply fate or coincidence, letting go of control and accepting that some things will happen in due time is a quality of which the importance is not to be underestimated. But how long do we have to wait? We always want to know. And that's the tough part. Not knowing makes it that much harder. Right now, I am writing this book with a toddler in the back of the car. A few minutes ago, she threw a tantrum. She screamed when we put her back in the car seat. She didn't want to be in the car seat. She had been there for almost 2 hours. But what was worse, she had no sense of time. Any of us could have told her, only about 1 hour left, and then we will be home. But how was she supposed to know, at her age, how long an hour is? To her, it felt as if she was going to be stuck in that seat forever. For us, as adults, what turns out to be months, years, or even decades may seem out of reach, insecure, and uncertain. Our loss is in the fear that we don't know if we will eventually have a better...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.